A bit
Okay.
believe soon.
All right. Now, my last question is, was there anything that you believe the president should have talked about in the sauna? I mean, it's very difficult to talk about everything, but you did say that he failed to address issues such as housing, well, the traffic and the PUV modernization program and the national debt. Some have said they would have wanted to hear the ICC, for example. So, ang daming ibang mga opinion. Pero what do you believe was an important issue that the president ignored or could have spoken about?
He did not ignore agriculture, pero parang kulang eh. I mean, puro promises, parang puro future tense pa rin ang agriculture. Kunyari, for example, i-connect natin, meron, sabi niya, yung first 1,000 days, gusto niya palakasin yun, di ba? We feed our children sa first 1,000 days. But hindi ba, di ba for sure, although sinabi niya DOST is developing some nutritious food and drinks, hindi ba automatically sa ang thinking natin sa first 1,000 days may gatas? May component ng gatas eh. Oh. Therefore, we will be importing all of this kasi ang production natin ng milk sa Pilipinas is 1% of what we need.
Interesting. Yeah.
So yung mga ganun sana, that's part of agriculture. So ano yung mga actual well, nag-distribute ng mga inahin, nag-distribute ng mga fingerlings. So, pero ano ba? Ano na? Did it lead to improved and increased production? So yun, sana more on he mentioned agriculture, but sana more on agriculture because yun talaga, ako paniniwala ko rin, Karen, you know, even this inflation thing can be anong tawag mo doon, fought with more production in food items eh.
Yeah, all right.
And then of course yung idea na about Kadiwa, I do not know how why the president is so impressed with Kadiwa, pero but it is a discount store. It's a pop-up discount store because you cannot locate a discount store in a permanent location because advantage ng community doon, sila lang yung access sa discount store. So it's parang anong tawag ba, it's a band-aid or a superficial solution. Ang hanapin natin is yung pangkalahatang pagbaba ng presyo ng pagkain because of greater production.
All
Ganun
right.
po dapat yun.
Uh-oh. So last word, Senator Pimentel, I think in what should be, I think what should the president watch out for, considering he had a well-received sauna, right, by all sectors, but what should he watch out for to ensure that he doesn't lose his political capital in the coming months, and especially with the midterm elections coming next year?
Well, improve the quality of the persons he will be appointing. Make sure that, you know, these people have public service in their hearts, no? Hindi lang yung posisyon ang habol nila. And then crack the whip on your people, make them all feel the urgency of the situation.
Yeah,
All
especially
hands
I think with inflation
hands
and
on
food.
deck.
Okay.
Again.
Especially with inflation and food prices.
Yes, so kasi ito lang ha. The president announced yung ako sa akin na unbelievable employment rate figures and also an unbelievable poverty rate incidence figure. That was on a Monday. And then 2 days later, Carina hits, the super typhoon hits. So I'm sure kahit yung figures na yon do not no longer hold 2 days after they were announced. So ano tayo, we have a lot of problems. Sabi ko, at least naka one down, 99 to go. Dun sa 99 still to be, so ano lang po yung figure of speech lang po yung 99. It can be 900, it can be 999 other problems. But you know, siguro the president should now impress upon his people, lahat ng appointees niyan, the entire bureaucracy, na we have to act with urgency. We have to analyze what is the real problem. Sa root cause na tayo, sa root cause tayo tumingin. Wag na po yung mga superficial, artificial, and temporary measures.
On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining me today, sir. It's been a pleasure. I do hope you return to Head Start soon. Thank you very much. Senate Minority Leader, Senator Coco Pimentel. Thank you.